svarstėte ir kviečiu jūs į 2020-2021 metų George Mason'o moterų krepšinio komandos pristatymą.
Hey, ik ben Vita, ik kom uit Nederland en we gaan nu naar coach Millison om te zien wat zij heeft te zeggen over dit jaar squad.
Welcome to Fairfax, Virginia and George Mason University. It's now time for our women's basketball preview and joining us is the head coach of the Patriots, Nyla Millison, entering her 8th season this year with the Patriots. And I don't know if you know this or not, coach, but you're only 5 wins away from having 100 here at the school. You'd be just the 3rd coach in program history to reach that milestone. So that's something to look forward to coming up this season. And thanks for joining us and welcome in.
Thank you. We're sure hoping we can get those 5 wins sooner rather than later. But, you know, I've enjoyed my time here and we want to just continue to build and grow this program.
Coach, let's start off with the youth of your team. You've got 8 players on this roster that are either freshmen or sophomores. You've got a couple of seniors and a grad transfer that will help bring them along. But I know you're excited about Deja Jefferson, your grad transfer from Georgia Tech. But talk to me about the youth, because that's where you're going to really depend on getting a lot of productivity is from the younger kids.
We are very, very young, but I like our youth. And I'm going to start with our sophomore class. We started with a class of 6, ended up with a class of 5. As the year progressed, we really were dependent on them last year to mix with our older group. And the majority of things that we couldn't control, injuries, illnesses, you name it, we had it in that freshman class, didn't get Vita eligible until December. So, you know, we need that class to be healthy and productive in order for us to be successful this season. And then we feel like we've added 2 quality freshmen, a local in Vanessa Lumbach, that we feel like can give us some minutes. And then Taylor Jamison, no doubt, as a freshman point guard, will battle for some significant playing time at the point guard.
Talk to me about how excited you are about Jefferson, your grad transfer. What does she bring to this roster?
Deja is a great addition, and I want to talk about her first as a person and a leader, personality-wise. You know, you're always a little nervous with the grad transfer sometimes, or even transfers in general, and how they're going to fit in. But she's got such a great personality just in terms of very level-headed. She is a great mentor. You know, she comes from a great program that both high school and college, and you know, sometimes they come in here and think, I'm gonna tear the world up, and she just comes in and works every day. So then you go to her as a player, you know, we really think she can be an impact, starting with her athleticism, her versatility, her length. She's a legit 6'3". Right now looks like we're probably going to play her at, you know, mainly at a 4 spot so she can step out. So she's going to help us on both ends of the floor. Defensively, you know, we can guard her multiple positions, but has the ability to shoot the 3, to post up. You know, we just look for big things from Deja.
You had an injury bug last year that kind of ran through the team. 7 different players missed some time, but as a result of that, every single player on the roster got to start at least 1 game for you last year. I imagine that experience of being able to start games can only help going into this season.
You know, Bill, we're going to look at that as a positive. At the time, it was very much a negative. We really did battle. We had 2 or 3 kids miss over 30 practices. As you just mentioned, we had 7 kids miss multiple games. You know, very, very frustrating never to be able to put a group on the floor. And I'm not one that likes to change starting lineups like you change your clothes every day. But that was what we were dealt with last year. But at the end of the day, we did get a lot of kids with a lot of experience. So we're going to take that as a positive. And, you know, right now we're just trying to all get on the same page again. COVID obviously threw a wrench into things getting started, as it did for everybody. But now trying to get on the same page and still battling some nagging injuries here and there, and some kids that aren't back yet. So we're taking one day at a time, as pretty much everybody else in the country is right now, and hoping by the time, whatever day it is that we start, we're ready to go.
Coach, your record from last year, really not an indication of how hard your team played. You had losses last year six different times by 5 points or less. You actually led the conference champion on the road going into the fourth quarter and had a shot in the final minute that would have either sent the game to overtime or perhaps even won. All that experience in those late games and losing close ball games, how do you take that and change it around this year?
It was very frustrating in terms of not being able to finish games, but you're right. We absolutely competed. We never quit. St. Louis, we played pretty well, and just coming down the stretch, didn't quite have enough to finish. I think the athleticism that we have is going to help that. We have really, really, really made an emphasis to share the ball, and hopefully we'll get a little bit more balanced scoring than we've had the last couple of years, which I think could really make a difference. But we've just been really preaching, you know, playing together, playing with energy, playing aggressive, playing with a motor. And then the experience that we gained across the board last year hopefully will allow us to finish some of those games that we weren't able to last year.
Atlantic 10 is always a tough conference. Five different teams won at least 20 games last year. Going into this season, who do you expect to be the tougher teams in the league?
I think you got to probably start with VCU as they return that powerhouse group of seniors that have started since they were freshmen, took their lumps and continued to build. I think SLU is going to be really, really tough. You know, it's right down the line. There's just going to be some really, really, really good teams. So, you know, we're hoping we can be in that mix of the upper half, get some experience early in whatever amount of non-conference games we have. We're not sure what that's going to be or going to look like yet. But hopefully be ready and be prepared when the A-10 season rolls around.
Coach, thanks for the time today. We really appreciate it. And I know things are scheduled to get underway on November 25th. We'll see what the schedule may bring. And if everybody wants to keep track of it, be sure to check out gomason.com for all the latest scheduling information. Once again, we want to thank head coach Nyla Millison for joining us. Right now, two members of the women's basketball team are joining us as we continue our preview. They are senior Marika Korpinen from Finland. She's a 5'9 guard. And also Cam Gatling, a 6-foot senior. She's from the state of Virginia. Ladies, thank you for joining me. And Marika, I'll start with you. It's been a weird offseason for you guys, obviously, with everything going around. You have a very young team this year with 8 freshmen and sophomores on it. How have you been able to, as a point guard and a leader on this team, kind of keep everybody together in what's been a really weird circumstance as far as practices go?
Yeah, it's definitely been a very different start for the year. We did not get the usual summer. We didn't get to physically meet each other this summer, but what we did get to do, we got to spend a lot of time on Zoom. We did 4 Zoom calls a week, and then we got to individually with one teammate really spend time together. Like every day you were supposed to talk to someone and really get to know them off the court. So I think that really helped us to get to know each other as people, not just basketball players, but get to know each other as who they are as a person, what they like to do off the court. And I think that has helped us to build those relationships that we need even on the court.
Kim, obviously a senior as well, and part of that young group is the post position where you play 4 freshmen, 4 sophomores. How do you as a senior kind of bring them along and teach them what it's like to play college basketball?
Yeah, you know, at first I thought it was going to be like a really tough thing to do, but the thing about that group of girls is that like they're really easy to talk to, they're easy to coach, they're like sponges. They soak in all the information. So it really hasn't been that hard for me, you know, trying to help them transition into this new program and everything that we're doing. It's been kind of easy because they're just so receptive and they take everything in and they just want to be the best for this team. So I really appreciate that about them.
You guys have an interesting roster makeup, not only the youth, but from all parts of the world. Marika, you're from Finland. You've got, including the United States, you've got teammates from 6 different countries. How do you blend different personalities, different backgrounds, different styles of basketball, I would imagine, into one cohesive unit?
Oh, well, I think that makes it just more fun. It's a lot more fun to have people from different backgrounds speaking different things. I mean, there's always the joke going around that there's a language barrier, but we know each other pretty well. On the court, there's always someone who's ready for a certain situation because we've come from all walks of life.
Cam, for you, obviously going into your senior year, your career numbers have been fantastic. When you get the ball, you're shooting more than 50% from the field overall. How much pressure is there for you to score now as a senior when you're ready to get back on the court, knowing how productive you've been in your first 3 years?
You know, it's always a little bit of pressure, but, you know, I try to see it in a different light. I see it more as like, you know, another goal that has to be reached. Just like something, a challenge, like to challenge myself, like to be better, to beat those numbers, to come out and give my team everything I got every single game. It's just another challenge that's in front of me that I'm ready to tackle.
Marika, your team lost 60% of its scoring from last season. So this year, where does the team find its scoring from?
I mean, it's of course always a challenge, but what we have focused on this time is really sharing the ball, having fun as a group on the court. So everyone has to understand that we're there together. Everyone's ready to score. Like, the goal is to move the ball, and we're just not going to have one or two people who are going to be scoring. It can be anyone. So not just relying on a couple people, but knowing that there are 14 people on this roster who are all capable of scoring, since everyone has a little more experience from last year.
Cam, you played on the WNIT team, obviously, as a freshman. Your high school team made a very deep run into the Virginia State playoffs when you were there. You take those experiences and you try to bring along this young team. What did you learn from those seasons about winning and what it takes to win that you can pass along to these younger kids?
The biggest thing that I learned is really that everything matters, like from the rehab to the diets to the constant repetition of everything that we're doing. It all matters so much, because in the stretch, it gets really hard physically and mentally, and you got to be prepared to that, you know, from game one. Every game is the biggest game, is because it's the game right now, and you just got to have that mindset all the way through.
All right, last question, and I'm going to ask it to each of you. Marika, I'll start with you. The one thing that you think your team needs to do this season to be successful?
I think we just need to trust ourselves and trust each other. There are going to be so many variables this year that we cannot control. So the only thing that we really can control is how we perform and how we prepare and how we really believe in each other and how we trust each other.
Cam, same question. In your mind, is the one thing this team needs to do?
I think we really need to have confidence. Just continue to understand that we belong here. This is where we're supposed to be. Everyone is just as important as the next person. And going out on the floor and just having a swag about ourselves and know that, you know, we're George Mason, we're proud. We're going to kick some butt.
Very good, ladies. Thank you for joining me for the preview. We appreciate it. The season is scheduled to get underway on November 25th, and we'll see you both out at Eagle Bank Arena.
Moi, mä oon Marika. Kiitos kaikille kuuntelijoille. Tässä on kaikki tänään.
Zdravo svima, moje ime je Milica Monelović i dolazim iz Crne Gore. Nadam se da ćete pratiti utakmice ove sezone i da ćete nas gledati i podržavati. Želim vam srdačan pozdrav sa George Masona. Ćao!